Mexico for a few hours, and getting stuck in the mud way out of nowhere, I made my way back to Route 66.
Alright, so that's where I messed up. Instead of 118, I went straight. That was my adventure for the day.
My little adventure in New Mexico, I was pretty happy to see Arizona. Now, the bike picked up some New Mexico war paint. Made my way over to the Petrified Forest National Park. Some of the views are just breathtaking. Really did have a hard time finding that forest, though. But the majestic sights certainly made up for it.
There is one thing I know. Some only want all that they see, but all that I have is all I need. Some only want all that they see, but all that I have is all I need, is all that I need.
A golden throne up out in the distance is I-40. America just driving on by. Listen, all this beauty. It's just stunning. Just gotta stop and take some time to enjoy the blessings and the beauty that this country offers. I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed to be able to be on this trip.
Riding the biggest rabbit in the world. What an amazing adventure today. Let's see what tomorrow brings. Well, good morning, Sedona, Arizona. Well, if you've never been to Sedona and you get the opportunity to travel from Flagstaff, go south on Route 89. It takes you through the canyon, and there are just the most spectacular views in that canyon. It was really hard for me to keep my eye on the road. Insisted that I go to Sedona. I'm glad I listened to him. He would probably say it was the first time I ever listened to him. Well, after Sedona, I headed back up north to Flagstaff. There's a lot of Route 66 history in Flagstaff. Old hotels, some have been there since the early 1900s. The Motel Downtowners sign has dominated the Flagstaff skyline for decades. And some of the best murals that I've seen on this road trip were in Flagstaff. My next stop was the Grand Canyon, and I was determined that this was going to be a trip of a lifetime. Those types that you never forget. Okay, right there, that ledge is where I was just videoing from. It's quite a view. Let's see if I can't get to the other side and see what the angle is from there. But wow, what a view. All right, here's the view from the other side. So that rock at the top there, that's what I was standing on. And you can see it has got a view. Perspective is always hard on camera, but just amazing. Amazing. Sheer size of the Grand Canyon. By now, I had met back up with Michael and Mark. This was their first time in the Grand Canyon. Michael kept telling me, hey, take a look at this site over here. A little closer, right there. Australian bastard. Well, Michael and Mark talked me into doing something that had been on my bucket list. A helicopter ride over and through the Grand Canyon. This promised to be one of those lifelong memories. We'll be right back. may be landing, but we were still soaring from all the sights that we had just seen over the Grand Canyon. If you ever get the chance to take a helicopter ride through the Grand Canyon, do it. Well, unfortunately, the boys are going to be taking off and heading west. I'm heading up north to Bryce Canyon. I can't thank them enough for talking me into doing the helicopter ride. It's a memory that I'm going to have for the rest of my life. Thanks, guys, for riding with me. You made the beginning of my trip just incredibly memorable. I'm so thankful for your friendship, and I look forward to riding with you. This time, I'll be in Australia with you.